everyone. My name is Sara Helou. Our topic for today is the cost method and the par value method regarding how to account for the treasury stock. Very interesting journal entry in this topic. Let's start our example. We have an issuance of 20,000 shares of a company, Company X, $4 par value common stock for $5.11 year 1. Then in May year 2, repurchase of $500 at $4. In June year 2, resale of 250 shares at $5. And resale of 250 shares at $1 in November year 2. You have to write down this example. And the best way to explain the difference between the cost method and the par value method is by using an example. So first, let's start with the following. We have the issuance of 20,000 shares of Company X, $4 par. Par equals $4. First, we're going to start with the cost method, and I will use the following. This is the original issuance. When you see issuance, you have to put that in mind. Issuance equals sales. And acquisition equals purchase. There's no difference. When you see issuance, that means sale. Remember, issuance, double S, sale. Issuance, it means sales. And acquisition, it's purchase. You have to know this and you have to keep that in mind. First, the original issuance. Issuance of 20,000 shares of Company X, $4 par. When you issue something, when you sell something, think about your cash. Your cash increases. And your cash increases in the debit side. So you debit cash for $20,000 of Company X, $4 par, for $5. So the selling price, the issuing price is $5. Okay? Amount of cash, number of shares, 20,000 shares, times the selling price, the issuing price, the $5 is $100,000. Then in the credit, it's always like this. You credit the common stock and you credit the APIC common stock. So the original issuance, it's always you debit cash because your cash is increasing, and you credit common stock and APIC common stock. You credit the common stock for the number of shares times the par value. The number of shares is 20,000 shares times the par value, it's given, it's $4, and you get a total of $80,000. What about the APIC common stock? It's the excess over the par value. So it's $5, the selling price, minus the par value of $4, times the number of shares, 20K shares. 5 minus 4, it's 1, times 20K, it's $20,000. So, let's repeat quickly. We have the issuance. When you see the issuance, it means it's a sale. It's a sale. Issuance equals sale. Issuance, double S, sale. Okay, of 20,000 shares of Company X, $4 par for $5. This is the first transaction. This is the one. So, the original issuance, when you issue something, your cash increases because you are selling, okay? You are selling, your cash is increasing. The debit side is cash, number of shares times the selling price. And you always credit the common stock and the APIC common stock. The common stock is for the number of shares times the par value, okay? And for, this is the selling price, this is par. And APIC common stock, it's APIC common stock. Do not confuse, okay? It's what is in excess of the par. It means the selling price minus the par times the number of shares. Second, in May year 2, repurchase. When you purchase something, okay, when you reacquire something, when you purchase something, you pay cash. So your cash decreases. Your cash is in that credit side. You repurchase 500 shares at $4. Okay, so always think about your cash. Always start with your cash. I'm repurchasing, I'm paying. Repurchase, when you purchase something, you pay. So your cash is in the credit side, okay? It's 500 shares, the number of shares. You purchased, or you repurchased the 500 shares at $4, times $4. It's a total of $2,000. And opposite to your cash, you have to have the treasury stock. Your cash is in the credit side. Your treasury stock is in the debit side. This is the cost method. What's the meaning of cost? We said treasury stock at cost method. So treasury stock, it's accounted at cost. What is the cost? The cost is the first repurchase price. So cost method. When you think about the cost method to account for the treasury stock, okay? The cost is the first repurchase price. In this example, the first repurchase price is $4. So it's $4. This is my repurchase price. Okay, this is my cost. I have to put the following cost. It's $4 because it is my first repurchase price. So $4. We are accounting by using the cost method. And the cost is $4 times the number of shares times the 500 shares I repurchased. It's $2,000. This is the second journal entry while using the cost method. So, while using the cost method to account for the treasury stock, you have to write down the cost. The cost is the first repurchase price. And here, the repurchase is for the amount of $4 per share. So, my cost is $4. Always think about your cash. Always start with your cash. And once you think about your cash, the second step is to account for the treasury stock. The treasury stock is opposite to the cash. And while using the cost method, you have to use the first repurchase price. In the second one, they said, in June year two, resale of 250 shares. When you sell something, when you sell, your cash increases. So you have to put the following. Your cash is increasing. You have to debit the cash because it's increasing for the amount of 250 shares are sold at $5. It's a total of $1,250. And as I said previously, the treasury stock is opposite to the cash. If the cash is in the debit side, then the treasury stock is in the credit side. And since we are accounting for the treasury stock using the cost method, so I have to do the following. 250 shares times the cost. The cost is the first repurchase price. It's $4, as we said previously, equals $1,000. The figure is not complete. There's something missing. In the debit side, I have a total of $1,250. And in the credit side, I have a total of $1,000. I still need to plug an amount of $250 in the credit side, okay? In the credit side, I have a gain, but this is not a gain that hits the income statement. This is a mathematical gain. Please do not confuse. Sometimes you will see some MCQs that will try to trick you by saying the following. What is the amount that is to be reported in the statement of income statement? In the statement of earnings? Zero. Because this is not an income that hits the income statement. This is a mathematical gain. It's APIC treasury stock. It's an equity account. APIC treasury stock, that's an equity account. Equity account. It's not an income statement account. It's not a real gain. It's a mathematical gain. It does not hit the income statement. It does not hit the statement of earnings. It's an equity account reported in the balance sheet, and it's a mathematical gain. This is how to account for it. The fourth transaction and the last transaction in this example, resale of 250 shares at $1. I'm selling, my cash is increasing. So I debit cash for the amount of 250 shares times $1 is $250. And as I said previously, the treasury stock, it's opposite to the cash. The cash is in the debit, the treasury stock, it's in the credit side. For the amount of, the number of shares, 250 shares times the cost. The cost, this is the cost method. The cost method, that means the first repurchase price. The first year acquisition price, it was $4. That gives me a total of $1,000. See, the debit side is $250 and the credit side is $1,000. Okay, I will write it here because I need some space to fill in the debit side. This is $1,000. What to do in a similar case? In a similar case, first, I will use two accounts. Try to take out of the APIC treasury stock of the mathematical gain you had as much as you can. So you take as much as you can from the APIC treasury stock, and the remaining is to be plugged against the retained earnings. In my APIC treasury stock, I had $250. That's the mathematical gain I had. So I can take out of the mathematical gain I had, I can take out of the APIC treasury stock only $250. Now I have $250 and $250, $500. It's not enough. I still need $500 to reach the $1,000. This $500 is to be plugged in the retained earnings account. Retained earnings account. Please pay attention. Retained earnings in the cost method, never in the credit side. You will never see the retained earnings in the credit side. Never, ever. Please pay attention. This is incorrect. The mathematical gain in the cost method, you do not use an income statement account. You just use the APIC treasury stock account, okay? And after that, while accounting for the last transaction, you have to take out of the APIC treasury stock as much as you can, and remaining, you use the retained earnings account. The retained earnings is always in the debit side, never in the credit side. This is while accounting for the cost method. Let's think about the following. What's the total for the equity accounts while accounting using the cost method? Okay, so the cash, it's not an equity account. I will erase it. The common stock, it's an equity account. I will leave it. Here I'm trying to calculate the total equity while using the cost method. This is the original issuance. The treasury stock, I will need it, it's in the debit side. I will erase the cash because it's not an equity account. It's a balance sheet account. It's a current asset account, but not an equity account. The cash, I do not need it. I just want to keep the equity account. When I say equity account, it means treasury stock, retained earnings, APIC common stock, APIC treasury stock, as I said previously, so treasury stock, APIC treasury stock, APIC common stock, and retained earnings. The cash, I do not need it to calculate my total equity. The APIC treasury stock, yes, I need it. It's in the debit side. And yes, I need the retained earnings. And yes, I need the treasury stock to calculate my stockholder, equity. Stockholder's equity, total equity. And as you said, no retained earnings in the credit side while accounting using the cost method. Here, everything in the credit side, it's a plus figure, okay? And everything in the debit side, it's a minus figure, let's say. We have so common stock, we have APIC common stock, we have the APIC treasury stock, the mathematical gain, and we have the retained earnings. Common stock, we have 80K. It's a plus figure because it's in the credit side. So plus 80K. Erase this one. APIC common stock 20K, it's a plus 20K because it's a credit figure. And I'll assume that everything is in the credit side is a positive figure. Treasury stock, it's in the debit side, so it's a minus. Minus 2,000. I have to add treasury stock. Minus $2,000. Okay. Credit, treasury stock, it's a plus figure. Plus 1,000. And APIC treasury stock, it's plus 250 in the credit side, plus $250. APIC treasury stock, minus 250 because it's in the debit side. Retained earnings, minus 500 because it's in the debit side. And treasury stock, plus 1,000 in the credit side. I have a total of common stock, it's 80K. APIC common stock, it's 20K. APIC treasury stock, zero. In this case, it's zero. Retained earnings minus 500 and treasury stock 2000 minus 2000, zero. In this case, it's it's zero. So the total equity is 80K plus 20K minus 500. It's 100,000 minus 500. It's 99,500. So my total stockholders' equity is 100K minus 500, it's 99,500. This is the total of my equity using the cost method. All right? I will erase. I will write 99,500. And let's redo this example using the par value method. It's called par value method. So to calculate everything related to the treasury stock, you have to use the par value. All right, let's start. The original issuance as usual. Issuance, you're selling, issue, sell, your cash increases in the debit side, and in the credit side, for the original issuance, you have the common stock and the APIC common stock. The cash, 20,000 share, and the selling price is $5, it's $100,000. The common stock, you use the number of shares, 20K shares, times the par, which is $4, it's 80K, all right? And the APIC common stock, everything that is in excess of the par, 5 minus 4, $1, times 20K equals 20K. This is the original issuance. And since I'm accounting for the treasury stock using the par value method, so while calculating the treasury stock, I have to use the par, which is $4 in this example. The second one, repurchase of 500 shares at $4. I'm repurchasing. When you purchase something, you pay cash. So always think about the cash. The cash decreases in the credit side for the amount of 500 shares times $4 is $2,000. All right, and as I said previously, the treasury stock, if your cash is in the credit, then your treasury stock is in the debit side. This is the credit side. So debit, treasury stock for the amount of 500 shares, I'm using the par, not the cost method. I'm using the par, so I have to use the par value while accounting for the treasury stock. I do not use the $4 repurchase price. I'm not using the cost method. So if I do the following, 500 shares times the par, which is $4. $4 par. This is not the $4 purchase price. This $4, the par, not this one. Okay? It's $200 as well. Okay, you have to think about the following. Par value method. The par value method okay? You are purchasing, repurchasing now. You have to make a pro rata. So I'm using the par value method. I'm purchasing or repurchasing or reacquiring. I have to make a certain pro rata regarding the APIC common stock account. What does this mean? Okay? I have to think about the following. PPP, APIC common stock pro rata. The original issuance, 20,000 shares. This is the original issuance, okay? This is the number of shares. The APIC common stock was $20,000. So the APIC common stock was $20,000. Now I'm repurchasing 500 shares. 500 shares. APIC common stock, how much? 500 times 20,000 divided by what is against the exclamation mark, the interrogation mark, question mark, the question mark is 20,000 equals, you simplify, you get $500. This is the APIC common stock in the debit side. So to calculate the APIC common stock in the debit side, you have to make a pro rata. And the pro rata will give you the $500. I take the original issuance of 20,000 shares, and the APIC common stock for these 20,000 shares was $20,000. I have repurchased 500 shares. How much? This amount times this amount divided by the amount that is against the question mark, and I get $500. All right, I have to plug something in the credit side, which is the APIC treasury stock. Here it's $500 as well. So this is the repurchase using the par value method. This is very simple, you just have to practice. When you practice more and more examples, you will understand the concept very well. I'm just trying to give you some tips. Now, the third transaction, in June year 2, resale of 250 shares at $5. As we said previously, always think and always start with your cash. When I sell something, my cash increases in the debit side. For the amount of 250 shares at $5, it's a total of 1,250 shares. If the cash is in the debit, then the treasury stock is in the credit side. I'm using the par value method. Remember this, 250 shares times the par, which is $4. It's a total of $1,000. In order to balance my journal entry, I have to plug $250 is in the credit side. The account to be plugged is the APIC common stock. It's not the APIC treasury stock. It's the APIC common stock while using the par value method. And finally, I have a resale of 250 shares at $1. Again, when I sell something, my cash increases. My cash increases in the debit side for the amount of 250 times $1, $250. And my cash is in the debit, so my treasury stock has to be in the credit side. My treasury stock, I'm accounting for the treasury stock using the par value method. So it's 250 shares times the par, the $4, it's $1,000. But this time I have to plug something in my debit side because the credit side is more than the debit. First, if you have APIC treasury stock, remember this, if you have APIC treasury stock, you have to take the maximum you can out of the APIC treasury stock. And in the second journal entry, I had APIC treasury stock for the total amount of $500. So I will use this $500 and I will take APIC I'll take out of the APIC treasury stock $500. This is a total of $750. I still need $250. The retained earnings plug figure for $250. You have to repeat this example, and you have to repeat other examples in order to understand this concept. Now, I will calculate the total amount of my stockholders' equity. While using the cost method, I got a total of $99,500. All right, again, cash, I do not need it. It does not take the equity account. Common stock, it's in the credit side, I need it. APIC common stock, I need it in the credit side. Treasury stock, I need it. Cash, I do not need it. Cash, I do not need the cash. Treasury stock, I need it. APIC common stock, I need it. I do not need the cash. Treasury stock, I need it. So, let's start. I will erase. And remember, my previous answer was $99,500. This was my answer. Okay, so stockholders' equity, common stock, APIC common stock, APIC treasury stock, treasury stock as well, and retained earnings. In the credit side, it's a plus figure. Common stock in the credit side, 80,000. I will use this one, 80,000. It's plus because it's in the credit side. APIC common stock, that's the same, plus figure for 20K. I have plus 20K. Treasury stock, it's in the debit, so it's a minus figure, minus 2,000. Minus 2,000. And debit, APIC common stock, 500. So here it's minus 500. APIC treasury stock in the credit, it's a plus figure, plus 500, plus 500. Treasury stock is in the credit, plus 1,000, plus 1K. And APIC common stock, plus 250. APIC common stock, plus 250. APIC treasury stock, debit side, it means minus 500. Retained earnings minus 250 because it's in the debit side, it's a minus figure. Treasury stock plus 1,000 plus 1K. 1K, 1K, 2K, minus 2K, zero. Treasury stock, zero. Retained earnings minus 250. This is the total. Common stock, 80K. Okay, let's write this down. I would like to say that also in the while using the par value method, you can never have retained earnings in the credit side. So retained earnings credit side, never, not while using the cost method and not while using the par value method, never. All right, so common stock 80K, APIC common stock 20K minus 250, 19,750. APIC treasury stock is zero, treasury stock zero. Retained earnings minus 250, 99,500. That's the same total amount we got while using the cost method. So total stockholders' equity while using the cost method is equal to the total stockholders' equity while using the par value method. The total of my stockholders' equity does not change. Now, I will give a very small example related to the par value method. Okay, we had 20,000 shares, issuance of 20,000 shares $4 par and $5 that was the selling price, okay? And we first said that the repurchase was a repurchase of 500 shares, repurchase of 500 shares for the amount of $4. Now I will change, I will say it's $6. And I will use the par value method. So the par value method, the original issuance, when I issue something, my cash increases in the debit side, 20K times the selling price, $5, it's $100,000. Comstock, the number of shares times the par value method, the par value amount, it's $80,000. And the APIC common stock is to be plugged, it's the excess, $1, 20,000 shares, $28,000. I'm using the par value method, remember, par. It means I'm using the par value to calculate the treasury stock. Repurchase, when you purchase something, your cash decreases in the credit side because you pay cash, okay? 500 shares times 6, it's $3,000. My cash is in the credit, so my treasury stock is in the debit side. My treasury stock is in the debit side for the amount of 500 shares times the par, the $4, equals to $2,000. Now, as you can see, you need to add something to your debit side. And as we said previously, you make a pro rata. For the 20,000 shares, the APIC common stock was equal to $20,000. What about 500 shares? It's 500 times 20,000 over 20,000, $500. So, in the debit, you put APIC common stock, as we said previously, for the amount of 500. But still, my figure is not balanced. My journal entry does not balance. 2,500. I still need $500. In this case, I have to use the retained earnings. This is regarding the par value method. And now, finally, I will write down something. You have to compare it to what we saw previously. Remember, treasury stock, while using the cost method, you use the first repurchase price. This is your cost. And accounting for treasury stock using the par value method, you have to use the par value. Cost method. I will write something. Please compare it to the example you have or to other examples you try to solve. Retained earnings. Where can I get the retained earnings account? And par value method. Remember, nothing hits the income statement. Nothing, absolutely nothing. While using the cost method, you will get retained earnings when you reissue at below cost. Reissue at below cost. We said that the cost is the first repurchase price and reissue is the selling price. When you reissue at below cost, you will have to plug a retained earnings in the debit side. Never in the credit side while accounting for the treasury stock using the cost method or the par value method. What about par value method? You will get a retained earnings account while buyback, it means repurchase, in excess of the selling price. This is case number one. You will have to plug your retained earnings in the debit side when you buy back, when you repurchase, when you reacquire in excess of the selling price, or when you reissue at below par. When you reissue at below par. Please go back to the example I explained previously. You will see this case, you will verify it. and you will see this one, and you will see this one, and you will verify it. Good luck. Thank you for watching.